some of the finest Christian people, some of the finest singers that you will ever meet. They're from Kinston, North Carolina. Is that right? Got that right? Would you make welcome to the Marion Civic Center for a live album and a live video, the Dixie Melody Boys.
Up and wiped away all my tears and set my feet on higher ground. He put a brand new feeling in this heart of mine, took away the darkness, made the light to shine, spread the joy around me, and I'm so glad about me, and I feel just fine. Every day is passing now, is sweeter to me. I am
nearing
home, getting closer to that land of eternal peace. Up underneath that shining dawn, I get so excited, makes me laugh and cry. Since Jesus came and saved me, now I'm satisfied. My sins have been forgiven, I'm on my way to heaven, and I feel just fine.
I feel
just fine.
Got heaven
on my mind. Joy
down in my soul.
Down in my soul. Save me. Save my soul, I want the world to know that I feel just fine.
I feel
just fine.
I've got heaven
on my mind. Joy
down in my soul.
Down in my soul. Save me. Save me. My heavy burden, cheating wrong.
He pointed
me to home. Happy song, gonna sing it.
Till I die.
Till I die. Say, Jesus, save my soul. I want the world to know that I fine. Say, Jesus, save my soul. I want the world to know that I feel just fine.
Yeah. I'm feeling
just fine.
Got heaven
on my mind. Joy
down in my soul.
Down in my soul. Save me.
Sweet peace you
gave me.
In Marion, Illinois. We love you here and appreciate your attendance tonight. What a crowd, what a crowd, and we're so thrilled to be here. It's not my first experience in Southern Illinois. I've been coming here for many years, and the crowd's not changed much. Well, a little. I notice as the folks were coming in tonight, I see a lot of gray hair in this auditorium. That's a change. Amen. And I'd love to do a song just for us more mature citizens, okay?
Well, I'm tired, I'm so weary.
Oh, sing it, old man.
But I must go along till the Lord comes to call me. Call me. So bright. night is as black as the sea. Oh, yeah.
Oh, there will be peace in the valley for me so fair. Oh, there will be peace in the valley for me. Oh, Lord, I pray. Well, there'll be no sadness, no sorrow, no trouble I see.
There will be peace in the valley for me. The man will be gentle, the wolf will be tame, the lion shall lay down by the lamb, oh yeah, and the beast of the wild will be led by a little child. I'll be changed from this creature that I have. Oh, yeah.
Oh, there will be peace in the valley for me someday. Oh, there will be peace in the valley for me. Oh, Lord, I pray. Well, there
thank you very much. It really is a pleasure to be here tonight, and many of my friends who are here and the ones who haven't seen us that much can look in these nice bright lights and tell that I am a year or two older than the rest of them.
Amen. They don't need bright lights to see that, do they?
But I love it. You know, I am blessed. I'm a very blessed man to have a bunch of guys who love some of the old music as well as I do. Now, I'm not fanatical on the old music. I do love new music. If it's written good and got good harmony, I love it. But I don't ever want to forget some of the old stuff. Now, this little fellow over here, the lead singer, brought me a song, and he says, have you ever heard this song? And when he played it for me, I said, what do you mean, have I heard it? I used to sing it before you was born, son. And he said, I love the harmonies in this song. You know, back in the old days, a lot of groups used to get together and just sing a song just for the harmony benefit, you know. And that's one of these kind of songs. Can we try that tonight called Listen to the Bell?
When I wake up Sunday morning, hear the church bells ringing, inviting everybody to the house of a thrill comes beaming o'er me when it dawns upon me. I'm walking in the path my Savior trod.
Listen to the bell.
Hear them ringing
every Sunday morning.
Hear them ringing.
Sunday morning.
Let us ring, ding a ling a ling.
Hear them ringing,
ding a ling a ling.
Wondrous singing, don't you hear those glad bells ringing?
Ringing all day long, join the happy song.
Listen to the
You know, there's songs that come along, you know, in this modern era that sounds like they were written back in the 40s and 50s. And I found one on a tape that sounds just like that. Let's do that one called He's Living. He's in there, guys. Nice old people.
We sure are.
And not only this baritone singer standing beside me, he's the finest Christian young man I believe ever had in the group, but not only that, he's a good politician.
Sure is.
He knew my weakness for these harmony type songs. And guess what? He wrote one. Amen? And the title of this song is I Have a New Song to Sing. Let's do that one.
likes to sing it all day long. When he saved me by his grace,
he
put a smile right on my face.
Now,
I have a new song to sing. I have a new song to sing.
I have a new song to sing.
Since I met my Lord and King.
Thank you so much. Let me introduce the group to you tonight. Special to me, I've been in this thing a long, long time, as most of you know. Been with the Dixie Melody Boys since 1961.
Good gracious.
You behave yourself tonight. And that is a long time, but to me it only seems like yesterday when I'm having fun like I am tonight. And the young fellows who make that possible, I want to introduce to you one at a time. A young fellow sings the first tenor, and you could look the world over and not find one any more dedicated than this young man right here from a beautiful little town over in eastern North Carolina. He's ready to go at the drop of a hat. And I want you to make him welcome here to Marion, Illinois. His name is Derek Boyd. How about a nice hand for Boyd?
Just a pleasure to be here tonight in Marion, Illinois. You know, for the last 6 months, we've been to a lot of different places we've never been before. Back in September, went out in the western part of Canada. November, we took about 15-20 days, went to the west coast. And all during that time, I'm sure most of you probably know, my wife was pregnant with our first child. About halfway through the pregnancy, she started having some complications. And there I was, we were in the middle of all that traveling to places we'd never been and just having the time of our life, but yet I had the worry on my mind of the problem she was having with the pregnancy. Till one day I was praying while we were on the road, and I started praying. I said, Lord, I need some help. I can't travel all over this country singing to your people and ministering, and I've got some problems back home that could be pretty serious. It seemed like the Lord says, why are you even worrying? Don't you know I'm standing right beside you? Amen. People, I got to thinking about that. Not only was he standing by my side no matter what I needed him for, but he was back home standing beside my wife.
Amen.
After all, he is the master physician. And I want you to listen to a brand new song tonight. It says just that. I hope the Lord is standing by you tonight. It says, stand by me.
Storms draw nigh and the breeze.
problem.
If tomorrow should bring me pain and grief, stand by me.
Stand by me.
Stand by me.
Stand by me.
Underneath your wings, let me.
I forgot to tell you a happy ending to the story. My wife gave birth to our first son, January the 21st.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God.
Not only that, he worked a way that I could be home and see it. So I praise the Lord for it.
If tomorrow should bring me pain and grief, stand by.
Derek Boyd, God bless you. What a song, amen. Let me introduce, before we go any further, a young fella back here on the drums. Now, we don't have a drummer, and said we're going to need one for this thing we're doing tonight, and I couldn't think of anybody else but one of the best friends I got, and he's from Goldsboro, North Carolina, and his name is Tim Bullins. Would you make him feel welcome here tonight? Brother Tim. I told him, I said, now, if you want to, you can do a solo tonight on those drums. He said, no, Brother Ed, playing for groups is what made me what I am today. So that's okay. Young fella that many of you, if you hadn't seen us before, you're probably looking up here on the stage and you're thinking to yourself, this next young man, boy, there's not much to him, is there? When you're talking about physical size, there may not be much to him. But what a voice he has, what a talent God has given him, and what a heart he has for gospel music. And I want you to make the biggest little man I know welcome. His name is McCray Dove. How about a nice hand for McCray tonight?
Yes. So glad to be here tonight to be able to say that I'm saved and I'm on my way to heaven. And I know I'm not very big at all. I'm used to that. See, all these, they bought these new suits for us and these ties, and mine don't even fit me. Believe it or not, I got the back of this thing stuffed all the way to the bottom of my socks. And it's just,
really? Show them right quick.
I don't want to show them. I have people all the time ask me, well, Craig, does being little, does it bother you? Well, not at all. Because us little people can get away things on tall people can never get away with.
Amen.
During the early spring or summer and fall, while we're on the road, we love to play golf during the day. And as a matter of fact, last summer, we stopped in Arkansas and found us a golf course. And Ed walked in through the door and looked at the man behind the counter and said, how much is the green fees? He said, well, for senior citizens, it's $3. Derek and Larry walked in. They said, how much is the green fees? The man said, they're $18. I walked through the door, just had to put my golf bag down. Derek said, well, Cray, the green fees are $18. The man said, not for him today. Kids get to play free. When I get to heaven, it won't matter how tall you are or how small you are. All that'll matter is if you've been born again. And I thank the Lord for his touch on my life tonight. Friends, I don't stand before you tonight because of justice, but I stand before you tonight because of the mercy of Almighty God. Eric, roll me out of there.
Shackled by your heavy burden, neath the load of guilt and shame, then the hand of Jesus touched me, and now I am no longer the same. Since I met this blessed Savior, oh, and since he cleansed and made this little boy, he made me whole. Oh, I will never cease. Oh, I'll never cease to praise him. I've got this child in white turning rows. You know why? He touched me. Oh, he touched me. Oh, thank God for his touch. And all the joy that floods my soul. Hallelujah. Something wonderful happened. If you have felt his touch tonight in your life, sing that chorus with us. He touched me.
Oh, he touched me.
Eric, you got to stop that music.
And all that bless my soul.
Lord, we thank you for your touch.
Something wonderful happened, and now I know he touched me.
you know, ever since that day, I've never been the same. I tell you what, I know I'm little, but I tell you something. When I want to shout, I shout. When Jesus touched me, he gave me something worth living for. And I don't know what you came here to do tonight, but I tell you what I come to do. I come to praise the Lord. My friend, I've got to praise the Lord. Listen to a brand new song. You may ask me why I'm happy, why I have a smile on my face. You see, I believe it's showing that I have a dose of my Lord's amazing grace. You see, sometimes I can't contain it. I got to share it with the whole wide world. I've got to testify, I'll never deny it. I've got to praise the Lord, cause I've got one more hand to raise. And I said one more tear of praise, and I'll be one more shout, glory, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, I'm saved.
Oh, I don't want to rock too proud in my place.
I'm not ashamed, stand up and give him the praise. You see,
I don't really worry about this whole world.
Church, it needs a revival, but revival starts with me and you. You see, there's a whole lot more than going to church and just sitting there on a pier. So the next time you feel forgotten, just remember you got a lot to thank him for. Just take a rightful place, you're a vessel of praise. It's time to praise the Lord, and I've got
one more hand to raise.
And I said
one more tear of praise,
and I'll be
one more shout, glory, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, I'm saved.
Oh, I don't want to rock and cry out at my place.
I'm not ashamed, stand up and give him the praise. You see,
I'm pretty worried about this whole world. I'm gonna praise the Lord. Rock and cry out in my place.
I've got to sing, stand up and give him the praise. You see,
I'm really worried about this whole world. I'm gonna praise the Lord.
You see,
I'm really worried about this whole world.
It needs a revival, a revival stuck with me and you. You see, there's a whole lot more than going to church and just sitting there on a pier. So the next time you feel forgotten, just remember you got a lot thinking for. Just take a rightful place, you're a vessel of praise. It's time to praise the Lord. And I've got
one more hand to raise. Rock and cry out in my place.
I'm not ashamed, stand up and even the praise. You see,
I'm really worried about this whole world. I'm gonna praise the Lord.
Oh, I've got
one more hand to raise.
And I said
one more tear of praise.
And I'll be
one more shout. Glory, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, I say.
Oh, I don't want to rock and cry out in my place.
Stand up and give him the praise. You see,
I don't really worry about this whole world. I'm gonna praise the Lord.
You see,
I don't really worry about this whole world.
Just remember, you got a lot to thank him for.
best ain't to rap a place. You're a vessel of praise. Hands high to praise the Lord. And I've got
one more hand to praise.
And I said one more tear of praise. And I'll be
one more shout. Glory, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, I say.
Oh, I don't want to rock too proud.
Sing, stand up and give him the praise. You see,
I've been worried about this whole world. I'm gonna praise the Lord
God. I've got
one more hand to raise.
And I said one more tear of praise. And I'll be
one more shout. Glory, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, I
say. Oh, I don't want to rock you around in my place.
I'm not saying stand up and give him the praise. You see,
I've been worried.
See now.
Settle down. Don't get that soup messed up. It ain't paid for yet.
No, folks, that's the kind of fun we have. Isn't it great being a Christian?
Amen.
Isn't it great being a Christian? Praise the Lord. You know, I can't even imagine what it was like to be a non-Christian. I really can't. I do remember those days, but I try not to. But I can't imagine how I made it through those days without knowing Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I love what I'm doing tonight. Does it show? Amen. Young fella standing next to me has been a blessing to me since he came with the group. We were looking a young man to fill that position, and I was, if you folks who know me, you know I'm a little bit choosy. That don't make me any better than anybody else. But it lets me know, it makes me know what I want, you know. And I've met a young fella that filled the bill in all categories. One of the finest, nicest young Christian men I believe I've ever had in the group. And I want you to make him welcome. He's all the way from Somerset, Kentucky, and his name is Rodney Griffin on the baritone. How about a nice hand for Rodney? Oh, me. Rodney, when Rodney came with the group, you know, I'm always trying to find a song that features the new person, you know, and introduce him to audiences across the country that way. And it seemed like I was having the trouble finding the right song for Rodney, you know, and one day I was helping the guys set up equipment. Well, I was watching them set up equipment, you know.
Right. There you're talking.
And I was sitting in the auditorium, and I heard Rodney singing a song. And boy, it was my kind of singing and my kind of song. I went up to the stage, and I said, "Where did you find that song?" He said, "Little McRae just wrote this song, and we're kind of trying to get together." And I thought it was great, and I wish you'd sing it for us tonight, if you will. Call when morning comes.
Jesus said, "No man knows." It could happen in the morning, so I'm just waiting for that dawning to appear. When morning comes and the sun shines on his children, when the clouds roll back and his love fills the air, there'll be a great celebration for the saints around God's throne. For the battle be over, the victory will be won when morning comes.
Now on that morning we may be standing before the Savior as he's crowned King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and we'll see our precious Lord. most of all, we'll see Jesus face to face.
When morning comes and the sun shines on his children, when the clouds roll back and his love fills the air,
there'll be a
great celebration for the saints around God's throne.
For the battle will be over,
the victory will be won when morning comes.
For the battle will be over,
the victory will be won when morning comes.
Brother Rodney.
You know what this reminds me of tonight? This reminds me of that beautiful morning.
Come on, come on.
When we're all gathered around the throne of God, watching our Lord and Savior being crowned King of Kings, and looking down his arms and seeing his hands where they were pierced, and realizing that those pierced hands were the very reason why we could be there. Oh, there's going to be some wonderful things happen that morning when morning comes. I'd love to sing that second verse if you'd allow this old Kentucky boy to do that.
Now on that morning we may be standing before the Savior as he's crowned King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and we'll see our precious loved ones in that city. Oh, but most of all, we'll see Jesus face to face.
When morning comes and the sun shines on his children, when the clouds roll back and his love fills the air,
there'll be a
great celebration for the saints.
You know, there's I love good songs. I listen to a lot of demo tapes. In fact, I listen to about everyone comes in, McCray, Derek. Most of the time we put them on the bus as we're rolling, you know, and we'll listen to them. And you'll be surprised at some of the good songs that are written today. And one that I had picked out, wasn't for sure whether we had time to put it on a record or not. And today I made a decision we were going to try. Written by a young man who's here in the audience tonight. And I just love what the song says. You know, Jesus was a miraculous miracle worker when he walked on this earth. Could have performed any miracle. Brought Lazarus out of the grave. Made blinded eyes to see again. The crippled to walk again. And he could have moved Mount Calvary just as easy. He wouldn't have had to go. But aren't you glad he did? Huh? We wouldn't be here tonight in the form we're in. Amen? Says, I'm so glad that he didn't move Mount Calvary.
At midnight in a garden with his soul in agony, Jesus cried out, Father, let this cup pass from me. Up ahead he saw a mountain where heaven and hell would meet. A hill he knew could not move, a hill called Calvary, and I'm so glad
he didn't move Mount Calvary. So glad that day he did not say, depart, be cast.
crown, the bloodstained brow, the plan to set men free. Jesus carried through, 'cause he refused to move the hill called Calvary. By the sound of his voice, the dead will see new life. At the touch of his hands, blind eyes receive new sight. And when he stepped out on the water, the rage and storm stood still. Skies turned blue, mountains move according to his will. And I'm so glad he didn't move Mount Calvary. So glad that day he did not say depart, be cast into the sea. The cross, the crown, the bloodstained ground, the plan to set men. Every proof, 'cause he refused to move the hill called Calvary. Oh, the cross, the crown, the bloodstained crown, the plan to set men free. Jesus carried.
Good song. Amen. I'm thankful for musicians just as dedicated as the singers are. And I know that many of you have had a chance to look at the young fellow at the piano tonight. And no matter what you may be thinking, he is thrilled out of his mind to be here. He really is. Amen. He is. Honest, he is. Now, this young man here is from a special, very famous part of North Carolina, and I've got to give it a little plug. He is from, and many of you may have passed through there on your vacations or something, he's from Spivey's Corner, North Carolina. Now, a lot of folks know that that truly is a famous part of North Carolina. They have an annual event there that draws many thousands and thousands of people, and that event is called a hollering contest. Why on earth they do that, I'll never know. But they do have a hollering contest. I think years ago it started as a hog calling contest because we're in a rural part of North Carolina. But now, as everything else, you know, it's gotten sophisticated. They got a stoplight at the crossroads out there now, you know. And now they've shortened that up to call it a hollering contest. And we were in Canada a couple of weeks ago, and I was introducing this young man. And when I said Spivey's Corner, I heard some clapping going on out there. They had heard about Spivey's Corner. And the way they heard about it, the winner of that event each year is on the Johnny Carson Tonight Show, and that's the truth, as Wendy Bagwell says, with my hand up. And this young fella is a member of that area of the country. And I asked him, did his family ever get into that hollering stuff? And he said, nobody but his mama. I want you to make mama's little baby boy welcome, Mr. Eric Pialis. How about a nice hand for Eric tonight? Thank you so much. Now, young man that people fall in love with rather easy all across the country. Did I call you? No, he is a very popular individual. He was with me. You know, I've been knowing this young fellow a long, long time. He was with his family group called the Singing the Lauder family out of Morgantown, West Virginia. This is our resident hillbilly. I want you to make him welcome, Mr. Larry DeLauder. How about a nice hand for Larry? I'll tell you what we're going to do. Many of you folks are seeing us for the first time. Now, Larry has stood behind us for 5 years now, making us sound good, you know, and putting a whole lot more music sound in and really back there. You know, he just makes a whole lot of music. And I had never thought about bringing him forward to let him be featured on an instrumental. I was happy hearing what I hear, you know. But one morning, about 6 months after he was with the group, we were in a large church in a major city in the South, and it was a first church, and we had hundreds of people there that morning. Thousands of people there that morning. The first balcony was full, the second balcony was full, all the seats on the main floor were full, and we were having a time singing our music, and the folks were worshiping the Lord in different ways, you know. And this is the truth. I looked over on my left, and there was one entire section in that big auditorium of some of the sweetest black people I believe I've ever met. You know, now, when you sing songs about Jesus to black people who truly love Jesus, they're not intimidated like we are sometimes. And they'll praise the Lord. And that morning, they were mm-hmm-ness to death, you know. And they loved it. And every time Larry would take that harmonica and bend one of those notes for a little feeling, you know, soul. Every time he would do that, I'd hear from that section over there something say, They loved it. That's what gave me the idea. I said, Larry, you've never done this for me before, but I know you can. I want you to bring that harmonica up, and I want you to play my favorite hymn of the church, Amazing Grace. Now, folks, this is the way the song started that morning. That's the way he was playing it, just like you heard it all of your life. And as he was playing, I want you to know the acoustics in that auditorium are perfect. And it sounded to me like the harmonica was flowing in and out of the mountain valleys, you know, just beautiful. In fact, I was getting a blessing. I had cold chills on my left leg. And I was raised in a Southern Baptist church, so you know it was hot there that morning. Amen. 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 But as he was playing the harmonica so beautifully, you know, I noticed there was a stirring in the camp over here in that section. They were having themselves a time, and there was a little fella. His hair was just as white as cotton. He was the size of a McCray dove right here. And he got out in that middle aisle, and he couldn't stand it. He'd skip up in that aisle, and all of a sudden he'd stop, and he'd listen to some more music, and he'd skip a little further. All of a sudden he ran back, and he said, "Jump on in, Jesus. Jump on in." Now listen, when he said that, I want you to know the mood in that auditorium changed, and this is the way that same song ended up. Listen. Tonight, and I said, "Well, I don't know yet. I don't like it." See, you got to understand Larry a little bit. When you give him too much advance notice, you might let things get out of hand, you know. So I said, I'm not sure. But Larry said, "If you do, what would you want me to play?" And I said, "Well, Larry, you know my weakness." I said, "When I was just a small child." I'm going to put him back in the bus. But this is the truth. A long time ago, when I was a small child, every time I heard a harmonica being played, to me it sounded like a choo-choo train.
I didn't know they had trains back
then.
They
did have trains back then. But I said, "Whatever you do, make some train sounds." He's got one. He thought about my old buddies, the Easter Brothers, wrote many years ago, called that Glory Bound Train. Let's see if we can get it together, Larry. I'm going to hold it for you. Go ahead, buddy.
West Virginia. If you like it, Miss Mary in Illinois, let them know. Hey,
there's a rumor going around that I'm jealous of Larry DeLauro.
Oh, that's silly.
I want you good folks here in Marion, Illinois to know tonight that I'm not jealous of nothing. But I've never got any kind of reaction from nothing I've ever done like you just gave that little harmonica for. Oh, no, it's too late now.
Hey, let me say this. You know, when I was a little boy, I used to go to concerts, and a man would come along, and I couldn't hardly wait to hear him sing. And I'd sit out there in that audience, and I would just dream and fantasize. And I told my daddy, I said, Daddy, when I grow up, that's exactly what I want to do. Well, I'm doing exactly what I want to be doing. I just ain't grown up yet. But that man was Ed O'Neill. And if you're glad to see Ed O'Neill singing the bass, how about giving him a hand here in Marion, Illinois?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, buddy. Amen. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you very much. See, I wrote a song one time myself. Well, I did.
I bet you did. Sure.
And some little fellas up in Bryson City, North Carolina, not too long out of high school, recorded my song. And, of course, all of y'all know that group is called The Inspiration. They recorded my song. They're not here tonight. I love them. They recorded my song, and as far as I know, they still sing it. Can we do it tonight? A song entitled, When I Cross to the Other Side of Jordan.
There's a happy, happy day of coming when I make a heavy burden stop. I'll sing around the crawling turtle as the saints all march around. Twin go when I meet the Savior, he's the one who died for me. When I cross to the other side of Jordan, just beyond that crystal sea. When I cross to the other side of Jordan, over on that Jordan shore. When I cross to the other side of Jordan, I'll live forevermore. Twin glory in the morning, only never comes at night. When I cross to the other side of Jordan, wherever Jesus is my life. I have so many loved ones who made this trip I know. Oh, how I long to